Mark 14:17, and the evening he cometh with the 12, and as they sat and did eat, Jesus said, Verily I say unto you, one of you which eateth with me shall do what? Come on, you're still looking for it? All right, Mark 14, verse 18. And as they sat and did eat, Jesus said, Verily I say unto you, one of you which eateth with me shall betray me. And they began to be sorrowful and to say unto him one by one, Is it I? And another said, Is it I? And he answered and said unto them, It is one of the 12 that dippeth with me in the dish. The Son of Man indeed goeth, as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. Good were it for that man if he had never been born. And as they did eat, Jesus took bread and blessed and brake it and gave to them and said, Take, eat, this is my body. And he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said unto them, This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many. Verily I say unto you, I will drink no more of the fruit of the vine until that day that I drink it new in the kingdom of God. And when they had sung an hymn, they went out into the Mount of Olives. Amen. Father, thank you this morning for the opportunity to commune with you once again. Thank you for reminding us that the price has been paid, that it doesn't matter what we are struggling with or what the battle is, that you have already prevailed for us through Jesus Christ. We thank you for the blood that was shed. Hallelujah. We thank you for the body that was broken for us. We thank you for the sacrifice that was made. We rejoice this morning, Lord, that it has brought us total and complete victory. We give you the glory and the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, shout it louder, amen. Amen. I believe it was some years ago that I spoke about this revelation about the disciples and their attitude to such a bizarre revelation. I mean, this is the Lord Jesus getting ready to leave. And they all gathered together. He gave them instruction on where this Passover should be prepared. And in the middle of it, he says, Now one of you shall betray me. And I said some years ago that what I found amazing was the humility in the disciples. What was that humility? They each were asking the Lord, Is it me? Most of us would have thought, I know who it is. Because we are always shifting spiritual responsibility to someone else. But they had the humility to say, Lord, is it me? Am I capable of this? Even though they weren't engaged in anything, but they still felt that they could be the one. And periodically, the Holy Spirit will bring it back, because after a while, you start feeling perfect. And even when you hear warnings, you don't think it belongs to you. Hallelujah. Did I say something wrong? And then you start picking out people who should be responsible for this thing. If the glory is not moving, I wonder what they did. Come on, I need to bring it home, you know. Because, you know, you're always thinking, you know, it's somebody else, but you never think, maybe I did something. Or maybe I missed something. They started asking, Lord, is it me? Is it me? Is it me? In another gospel, even Judas joined in. Lord, is it I? Even though he knew. And the Lord said, Thou sayest. You notice how the Lord never answers things directly. Hallelujah. Okay, let me move on. I was going to make a little comment there, but you haven't warmed up yet. If you had warmed up, I would just put in that there. All right. So, but you notice that most times he never answered their questions directly. Sometimes he'll answer a question with a question. Yeah. And I was going to say that most of you ladies will not be happily married to him because he will not answer your stuff. I'll just ask 1,000 questions. You know? You see? So, but I found this amazing. Listen carefully, because this was just before the enemy was allowed to arrive for them to arrest him. And this is usually what happens, that God will begin to allow life to ask you questions to make sure that your faith is intact.
Yeah. Amen.
Because we fasted 14 days. Now we must believe that God answered.
Amen.
If we don't believe that he has answered us, then we were just hungry. Amen. We be hungry.
Amen.
But no, we... I can't make it up, you know. We need breakthroughs to manifest. And faith and sacrifice must go together.
Amen.
And he said, one of you shall betray me. Amen. Now, what was he saying? Satan has found a way to enter into our camp.
Yeah.
And he says, one person is responsible. The question, is it me? Or is it you? Or is it a thought? Or is it anything? You see? And Jesus said, it is one of the 12. That showed me for the first time, I'd always assumed that it was only the 12 that was with him at that Passover. But he said, it's one of the 12, meaning there were other people in that room beyond the 12. Have you ever seen it? He wouldn't say it's one of the 12 if nobody else was around. So that a whole lot of people were there also asking, is it I? Because some of the things he said was huge. He says, now, this job, somebody must do it, but it's better for that man not to be born.
Amen.
You see? This text always shows me why Satan succeeds among us. What is it? We don't know the scriptures. Do you think if Judas knew the scriptures that he would follow through? Because the thing was so precise. Even, come on, Elder Bobby, help me. What book of the Old Testament is where they mention the 30 pieces of silver?
Zechariah.
Okay, is Zechariah? Are you sure? We're on TV. But one of those, it says that even the price will be 30 pieces. So if you go to negotiate and it's 30 pieces, if you knew the scriptures, you will run for your life. But if you don't know the scriptures, things will be happening. You keep going along.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Confirm, I'm waiting. Huh? Is Zechariah? Okay, good. Oh, come on, give the elder a hand. Hallelujah. He's my resident theologian, you know. I always refer over there when I'm not sure. You see? And so I noticed that so many things happen with us because we don't know the scriptures. You remember Jesus told the people, he says, you err because you do not know the scriptures, nor the... Thank you, my children. The power of God. Look at all these people. Only my children remember that scripture. You said something. I didn't hear you. You should have spoken up. Your answer wasn't confident. Should I collect $10 from all of you for not knowing the scripture? It says you err because you do not know the scriptures. In other words, it says we make a lot of errors for not knowing what the word of God has said. Hallelujah. And not only that, if you don't know what the word of God has said, the power is hindered.
Yeah.
Because every fast we have fasted, every prayer we have prayed, every decree we have decreed is hinged on one thing, what God has promised.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And we must know what he said for us to get the breakthrough that he has promised. Otherwise, we are running on our emotions.
Amen.
But heaven and earth shall pass away. Hallelujah. Yeah. But the word of the Lord will not. Come on, you have to know that. Eh? Heaven and earth shall pass away. Okay. That word will not pass away. Okay, Jesus said in another place, not one jot or tittle shall pass away till all be fulfilled. Amen. Hallelujah. You can see most of you are mumbling. Hallelujah. You need to read the Bible. Hallelujah. Because if you don't read the Bible, even hearing from the Lord will get contaminated by Satan. And you will not even know when it happens. You know, one of our spiritual daughters came to me during the fast this week. He said, pray for me because I feel like my prayer is lagging. I said, no, I don't need to pray for you. What's missing? I said, go read the word. Your spirit man is weak. You notice how you feel weak when you are fasting? Because the body hasn't eaten. That's the way the spirit feels when there's no word.
Amen.
So when you can't pray in tongues, when your prayer is not flowing, you go back and start reading the word. You feed your spirit until it jumps back up and starts moving. And so when Satan comes in with his tricks, you recognize him for who he is. Hallelujah. So I'm telling you this morning, as we come to the table, let us be cognizant of whatever the Holy Spirit is speaking to us. Let us take responsibility for ourselves that this bread and this wine will still answer every issue in our lives. Now, there's this thing that always excites me when I read it. It says, this blood is the new covenant. Why does it excite me? He said, this is the only reason God will answer me. Not what I'm doing or not doing. I need to put my faith in this thing. To save me, to heal me, to deliver me, to guarantee what God has promised. Come on, you ought to celebrate the blood.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
The body was broken for the blood to be released. Okay. I want to release this to you before we commune. Watch this. The Bible says that when Jesus was crucified, the moment the blood came out of him and touched the earth, what happened? There was an earthquake. He said, even dead folks came out. So if you will allow the blood of Jesus to impact your heart this morning, come on, let's have some earthquakes. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let dead things come alive. Hallelujah. Let there be a release of glory and victory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, let your blood speak this morning. Let your blood cause an earthquake this morning. Let your blood cause resurrection this morning. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank God for the blood that redeems me. The blood that justifies me. The blood, hallelujah, that makes me righteous. Hallelujah. Thank you for the blood. We celebrate it this morning. We thank you that as we come to this table, this blood has justified us and made us righteous. Cause your word, the body, the blood, to come alive in us, O Lord, that we may understand our purpose, that we may understand what you have accomplished for us, that we may eat and be filled with your spirit. Beloved, this morning, when you receive this bread and drink this wine, you will be filled afresh with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. I say it again. This morning when you receive this bread and when you receive this wine, you will be filled afresh with the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name. Come on, lift your hands and receive that decree. Father, I decree in the name of Jesus that we will be filled afresh with the Holy Spirit as we commune with you in the body and in the blood of Jesus. Thank you for new life, fresh fire, fresh glory. Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you for earthquakes. in this room this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you for joy. Thank you for liberty. Hallelujah. Thank you for glory. Thank you for a shout. We give you the glory and the praise in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come on, shout amen like resurrection angel. All right, that's a brief exhortation. I got three services in Jesus' name. Come on. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Receive the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. 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 In Jesus' name. Glory to God. Fire. How many of you want fire? Receive fire! In Jesus' name. Fire! Hallelujah. Fire! Fire! Afresh. Come on, if you feel a laughter, laugh. Feel a jumping in your spirit. It's called the fire of the Holy Ghost. I can't come in between the lines, but you can receive where you are. You see, that's it. You're getting it there. It doesn't matter where you stand. Take it. Take it. Take it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you're open, you receive. I told you, as soon as you eat that bread and drink that wine, you'll be filled afresh with the Holy Ghost. I don't make it up. Hey! Come on, I feel like fresh water falling on me. Awesome in power. Thank God for changing this atmosphere.
Yes, Lord.
And filling it with glory and fire. Glory and fire. Glory and fire. Hallelujah. Experiencing is her. In Jesus' name. Fire! We give you praise in Jesus' name. Come on, somebody shout amen. Shout hallelujah. God bless you. You may be seated.